In this video, I'll demonstrate uses for Exponential Audio's incredible reverbs, now a part of the iZotope family, in a post-production context. We'll focus on how to blend automated dialogue replacement, or ADR, within a new acoustic environment of a scene, and how to artfully situate Foley and sound effects against footage with reverb. Let's start with the ADR example. In this scene, a woman is heard off-screen knocking on her son's door to see if he's still awake. Her dialogue was recorded in a studio, not just behind a door as you might be fooled into thinking. Have a listen to the dry studio audio first.
Hey, Ben.
First step.
You up?
And here's the same dialogue after it's been treated with Exponential Audio's Symphony.
Hey, Ben.
First step.
You up?
Let's explore the settings used to achieve this effect with Symphony, an iconic character reverb and the most fully featured successor to R2, R4, and R2 Surround. First, we're using a preset rooted in the Room keyword folder. In this case, it's the TM Small Room preset, which was especially fitting to match the close quarters of the space on screen. You can also search for presets by name, application, or category right from the plugin itself. A few things that make the setting special. Bringing the tail width slider all the way to the left helps to cinch the stereo image of the late reflections, narrowing them, essentially. If I bring it all the way to the right and make the late reflections extra wide, it sounds like her voice is in a larger room than the cozy space we see on screen.
You up?
Let's narrow that down.
You up?
Also, by essentially low-passing the EQ profile of the early reflections, we bring her voice closer sounding, warmer even. By now, you've noticed that Exponential Audio's tools offer deep control over every aspect of the reverb. The frequency profile of the reflections is no exception. For example, we can change the filter shapes, Q, and adjust the level of the reverb for the early and late reflections. Listen again. This time I'll undo the low-pass filter to allow more high-frequency information to factor into the sound of the reverb on her voice. Notice how it makes her sound further away, if not thinner sounding overall.
You up?
So performing the low-pass brings a warmth and proximity to her voice that's more suited to the scene.
You up?
Let's do one last before and after, with and without reverb, before we jump to another session.
Hey, Ben.
First step.
You up? Hey, Ben.
First step.
You up?
In this scene, we have a doctor walking down a hallway. Originally, the scene had no sound whatsoever, until FX and Foley, processed through Exponential Audio's reverbs, brought the sequence to life. I'll play it first without any reverb, and then with the reverb. And then we'll go through the settings. While we have both FX and Foley running through Exponential Audio's reverbs, we're going to focus just on the footsteps and how to create the illusion of placing them in a large hall, as you see here. Two reverbs are sharing the work. The first is Symphony, used here as a mono reverb. We're using the empty special preset, which is rooted in the large keyword preset bank. This reverb is used to color the important information in the middle or center of the stereo field. Let's hear it in isolation from the other reverb. We're also sending the footsteps to Stratus 3D. Stratus combines an unobtrusive, natural sound with unparalleled user control. It's through this reverb we're filling up the sides of the stereo field. In fact, we've gone to the main balance tab and turned off any early and late reflections being sent to the center channel. so that Symphony can handle the mono reverb. The preset we chose here is called Down the Hall from the Medium Live Spaces keyword bank, the perfect preset to situate the footsteps in a long corridor. Let's hear this reverb in isolation from Symphony. And here they are together. Once more, we'll do a complete before and after of all the reverb. Let's jump over to another session. In this final session, we have another scene that came with no production audio, but was later brought to life through Foley effects and exponential audio reverbs. Have a listen to the before and after. I'm going to focus on the hits to the punching bag, all of which are heading through Neutron 2 and then into Stratus 3D. We're using a preset from the classical keyword bank called Squashed Church. This is built from a chamber-style reverb algorithm, which is ideal for the spacious empty gym that we see here in the scene. Let's look at the early reflection EQ curve. We're using a notch filter here to remove any resonance that might have been amplified as a result of the addition of reverb. Similarly, we're notching out high-frequency content of the reverb tail, which helps to bring focus to the attack portion of the punches. Let's undo these moves to demonstrate the subtle yet important differences. We've also engaged the warp section of Stratus, which contains transparent compression and limiting controls to shape the dynamics of the reverb, as well as overdrive settings to add even more color to the reverb. Let's do another big before and after. All the reverbs on the dialogue, FX, and Foley will be bypassed and then unbypassed. Thank you for watching. Hopefully this video gives you a better sense of the power, versatility, and customizability of Exponential Audio's reverbs in a post-production environment. Take care.